Jamie, let's talk about budget 2023. What's in it for Canadians? And I guess right out of the gate, let's maybe start with tax measures affecting high income earners.
So the government followed through on its promise in last year's budget to update the alternative minimum tax. So if you're not familiar, the AMT is a parallel tax calculation that basically allows fewer deductions, fewer exemptions, and fewer credits than under the ordinary income tax rule. So under the AMT system, currently, there's a flat 15% tax with a standard $40,000 exemption. That all is changing starting in 2024. So as of next year, the government being concerned that high-income Canadians are not paying enough personal tax, a new AMT regime will take into effect. Under that AMT regime, first of all, they're going to broaden the AMT base. So under the regular system, we know that capital gains are only 50% taxable. Under the new system, 100% of the gains will be taxable, similar with employee stock options. Under the current system, when you donate publicly traded shares to charity, there's no capital gains tax on the appreciated capital gain. That will change under the AMT system when 30% of gains will now be taxable in the AMT base. In terms of the various deductions and expenses, under the new rules for next year, the AMT base will be broadened by disallowing 50% of various deductions, things like employment expenses, moving expenses, child care, and deductible interest. They'll also now going to reduce the amount of non-refundable credits by 50%, subject to few exceptions. Notably, dividends will be fully taxable, no gross up, but no dividend tax credit. On top of all that, exemptions going from 40,000 to about 173,000, which is good. But what they're doing is they're bumping up the AMT rate from 15 to 20.5%. So what does this all mean? It means that this will generate over the next 5 years, $3 billion with a B, $3 billion of additional revenues. And they're estimating that 99% of the AMT will be paid by individuals who make more than $300,000 a year, 80% of that AMT actually being paid by those who make over $1 million annually.
Let's talk about what the federal government is doing to help Canadian households, specifically with a grocery GST credit.
Yeah, so I mean, interestingly, you know, most people don't pay GST on groceries because it's a basic exam zero rated. But effectively what happens is starting immediately, once the legislation is passed, the government will be handing out extra money to those recipients of the GST credit. Now, the GST credit helps to offset the cost of people who pay GST on purchases of goods and services. It's really for low and modest income Canadians. So what's going to happen is the budget is proposing an increase in the amount that we all got, or those who qualified got in January. This is going to be called the grocery rebate, and individuals that qualify will be getting an amount equal to twice the amount they would have gotten in January 2023. And that maximum amount would be $153 per adult, $81 per child, and $81 for those eligible for the single supplement.
Let's just go down the list here. Tell us about the changes to registered plans.
Okay, well, right off the bat, they've confirmed that the new tax-free first home savings account will be able to be offered by financial institutions if they're ready as of April the 1st, which is just in a few days. There's a small change to RESPs, education savings plans. There's currently a limitation of $5,000 of educational assistance payments in the first semester. That's going up to $8,000. And there is also a change to registered disability savings plans for someone saving for someone with a disability that qualifies for the disability tax credit to basically allow for children who are over the age of 18, broadening the definition of a qualifying family member that can open up the plan. That can now include a sibling that is able to now set up an RDSP for that sibling with a disability, as well as extending the rule to allow a parent, spouse, or common law partner to open up an RDSP for someone with disability by another 3 years until the end of 2026.
What wasn't in the budget?
Yeah, well, a couple of people were talking about potentially a new high income tax bracket for making high income. That wasn't specifically addressed, although one could say it was addressed through the introduction of the AMT. Similarly, The capital gains inclusion rate remains at 50% generally. However, it certainly was addressed as part of the AMT for the highest income earners.